But yeah, he can hit the ball really hard. I mean, these guys, for me to hit them balls, I'm sometimes concerned that they might hurt me in practice. You know, I'm afraid they might hit me with a ball and hurt me. Then we got Miguel de Rueda from Mexico. He is, he's been great. I think he only lost one match. Mm-hmm. Dominic lost two. So he's been super. He plays number two. Gustavo Marangoni, he transferred from Oakland City University there out of Indiana. Him and Miguel in doubles didn't lose at all. They were undefeated in the fall. And Gustavo, not only did he lost a singles match either, so mm-hmm. he was perfect playing number three and in number one doubles. So he's been great. Number four is Vanja Bojanovic from Serbia. Mm-hmm. He's got a really big serve and a huge forehand. I mean, he's great too. There's not a whole lot of difference between one through four. Mm-hmm. I have them play each other in practice all the time, and you know, there's mixed results there. Mm-hmm. So it's really good to have those top four that are almost interchangeable. So they've been just super. They've got good attitudes. Their GPAs are like 3.8 or better. So yeah. They're smart guys. So that helps. Mm-hmm. So they're definitely going to always be eligible. So, and then I added Fabian Segreda. He transferred from Wesleyan College out of South Carolina. Mm-hmm. He's a junior.
Yep.
And he's a solid player. He's playing number five singles and number three doubles with Dominic Hoffman. And Dominic, who was one last year, is now playing six, but he's totally fine with that. He has a better chance of winning there. He understands that, and he was totally fine with dropping to six. Then we've still got JR at Kilgore at seven, and he sometimes plays in the doubles and subs in singles. So, mm-hmm. again, we got seven guys. Actually, we've added another guy, Pierre. Yeah. So we're hoping to get him eligible as soon as possible. So we've got eight guys right now. But again, the fall was, well, I mean, it was great. But now we won a couple of close matches. We could have easily dropped a couple, but mm-hmm. we pulled them out like with 4-3 scores. So
yep.
really had a lot of, we were very competitive, and we had a strong drive to win, and that's what helped us pull out some close matches. So I can't say enough about the fall, but now we have the challenge of course, the conference schedule, which is much tougher. The teams are going to be playing now. Not that we didn't beat good teams in the fall, but now we're going to be playing against teams whose UTRs or their tennis rankings or ratings are as high or higher than ours. Mm-hmm. So we know we're going to be up against it, starting with Saturday against Lenore Ryan. Yep. We expect a tough match there, no doubt. But we feel like we have a chance, and that's what we're excited about. We have a chance to win a conference match now, so we're looking forward to that challenge and opportunity.
Yeah, this Lenore Ryan team, they went 13-8 last year. They had some success in conference play, 9-3. So, I mean, I guess scouting them out, how are you feeling, you know, playing against them this weekend and just getting ready for conference play just in general? Because right after Lenore Ryan, you do get a little bit of a break there and you play North Greenville, which is out of conference. But right back in middle of March, you play Newberry and then it starts back up. Newberry, Mars Hill, Catawba, Coker. I mean, every single one of them. Yeah,
every weekend we're going to be playing conference matches starting in March mainly. March and April, it's pretty much every weekend.
Yeah, yeah. So kind of just talk about conference play there a little bit.
Well, like I said, these teams are good. We have, like I said, we went international this year. Mm-hmm. Just need to win 4 points, so we're happy with seven.
Mm-hmm.
And but they're good. They're all good players, and we know what we're up against. Lenore Ryan did lose some of their top guys from last year, but they've replaced them with good players, clearly. And but we think we have a chance. Looking at their UTRs, that's the individual players' ratings.
Yep.
Like I said, if you're a 12, you're just pretty great, pretty much. We don't have any 12s on our team, but we've got 10s.
Yep.
And 9s, which is a big upgrade from last couple of years. And I think Lenore Ryan's top four guys are 10s, so they're really good players.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean we can't beat them. If we're a 9 playing a 10, it still could be a close match, and we think we have a chance. And, of course, all the other conference teams are really good, and some are even better than Lenore Ryan. So, mm-hmm. but like I said, we know now we can compete, and we will not beat 6-0, 6-0. We feel like we have a chance to fight for sets now, 6-4, 7-5, 7-6, whatever. So we are happy to be competitive.
Yes. Oh, that's awesome. That's good to hear. Well, thanks, Coach. UVA Wise faces Lenoir Rhyne at home this Saturday with a 2 p.m. start. Check out a match recap and all results on UVAWiseCavs.com. Thanks so much, Roger.
Thank you.